people back here, Rob. These people.
Yeah.
How you doing in the back of the house? You know, from back here, it's more like, it's less like seeing Loudon Swain and more like the Fisher-Price Little Loudon Swain set. You're just so teeny tiny. Oh, I'll let you teeny tiny little boar hop. You're like the shrinky dink version of yourselves. The Christmas ornament version of yourselves. You're just so cute from back here, guys. You know what? Jared and Jensen are gonna look like our height from back here. That's unsettling. What do you think back in the house? Are you excited to be here? Henry, you better be putting on an A-plus show. You want some half-assed D-minus kind of performance on a Sunday? Look up the Vampire Diaries conventions. That's what you need. We're not Vampire Diaries. We don't keep any kind of diary, except for our personal journals, and that's none of your business.
I did.
None of your business. What is your business? It's our business. It's con business. It's supernatural business. It's the business of beauty and hope. You people right now are gearing up to see perfection in pants. Flowing hair. Hair that literally could do its own panel. And still be cut off due to time. Too many questions for the hair.
It still outsell our panel.
Yeah, well, it probably will. The photos of the hair go for just a skosh more than ours combined. You're going to see rippling muscles, lumber sexuality in its most pure form. It truly is awe-inspiring. It's the kind of thing that gets us up in the morning. A lot of times we think, we need a Saturday morning, we need a Saturday night special. We're shot. We can't do it. Forget it. Phone it in. Bring in that backup band we have sitting back there ready to go at a moment's notice. The Loudon Swain robot ensemble. Fire up the robots, they say. But wait a minute. Hold the phone, we say. This is Jared and Jensen. We can't let the robots do that. In the future, we might let robots do Friday and Saturday, but we will always
do it.
Hey, listen, robots gotta eat. I don't like anywhere near you do, but we get angry calls from their robot agent saying, why don't they get a piece of the pie? You keep taking them on the road and they never work. The robot agent is a real robot a-hole.
I thought this was for patients.
I just heard that my boys flew coach. What the F?
Yes, we actually really do have robot Mike Borhan on stage with us. We haven't seen the real Mike Borhan in years.
This is actually true. I wasn't going to out it, but Mike Borhan is a robot. Hard to explain. Just trust us on this one. Well, you're so fired up. How many people here have never been to a supernatural convention? How many people in that group have created a faux relationship between themselves and Jared and or Jensen? But you can fabricate the possibility of an actual union here today because you're going to see them in person.
Yeah.
You're going to have a photo op.
Yeah.
You can create a real faux connection. With Jared and or Jensen.
Just cut around the picture.
Yeah.
And put it on a different backdrop.
And put them, and you know, I assume you brought the bridal gown for today. Put that on. Later on, digitally add the tux. Oh, good. Phew. I don't know. Oh, yes, there she is. Oh, that's unsettling, ma'am. It'll be easy in the deposition. Did she look like she was serious about wearing them? Oh, yeah, very serious. Very easy.
Oh, was she like wearing a wedding gown?
Oh, officer. Yeah, she was. It was. Yeah. Not subtle. This one. Row three, I said.
No, but you cut the picture out, you put it like on the edge of like Niagara Falls. Or...
Yeah, yeah, put a little bow tie on Jared and Jensen.
Say this is our honeymoon.
Or maybe you just take their head and find a shirtless picture of Lorenzo Lamas.
Right.
Put it over. You look great, you're in a gown, he's shirtless, best wedding ever. And then you send it to your parents and say, see, you're wrong, he does love me, now leave me alone! No, we're not going over Christmas, because Jared likes to spend time with his family, and that's where we're gonna be. Yeah! better not cut off that card. You, Dad?
Yeah.
Dad?
Yeah.
Your faux wedding. This is the day of your faux reception. And we're all here just guests at your faux event to celebrate your faux love.
We're your wedding band.
We are. It's your wedding band. But by the way, we're like a pretty substantial faux tip.
Faux tip.
Like a faux tip at the end. And we'd like to visit the faux buffet during breaks, if that's cool with you. The faux chocolate fountain is mighty tempting to robot Mike. I love chocolate that pours.
Don't let it touch me.
Rush my friends and I will not be able to play robot bass. So exciting. Oh my gosh, Jerry. And Misha! What's up with you, Misha? Oh my god, how many of you people, I mean, not since the biggest boon to the Trusco business since World War I and Flashers. Castiel. How many people are dressed as Castiel today? Or did this weekend? Any Castiel cosplayers?
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of you are lying to yourselves. I see a lot of you wear dresses that look like Castiel. A lot of you wear, like, you know, onesies that look like Castiel, swimsuits look like Castiel, Castiel tattoos all over your body. You people love using Castiel.
Ow!
I know that about you people.
I've got the undies on right now. Misha Collins undies. Which is actually no undies at all.
Well, I know I'm not wearing underwear, why do you ask? This is so exciting. We know what it's like for you. Yes?
It's not just JJ.
It's not?
For Misha.
Oh, we're not stopping there?
The King of Hell is in the house.
Hell's in the house? Unreal. I mean, that's an A show.
I'll give you a cherry on the top.
So, come on.
Tahmoh Penikett.
Tahmoh Penikett! But there's a like cartoon moose backstage holding a red stick, and it says you must be taller than this to appear on Sunday. Rob and I can't appear on Sunday. So that's why you'll never see us answer. We're not legally allowed to answer questions or do photographs or anything on Sunday because we're not taller. There's a height restriction. How exciting is this for you people? I mean, how fired up are you right now? And you know what's crazy? Like a drug, you'll spend the same or more next year. That's what it is. It's not fiscally responsible. You know what? A lot of times, love ain't fiscally responsible. A lot of times, that kind of relationship, you can't fall prey to what you can and can't afford.
And it's like, you know, the man you love, you gotta take him to a nice dinner.
You gotta do something. You gotta buy me this one photo up and tell the story. Three, really.
Then you're dating.
Three, in certain states, three photo ops means you're literally in a relationship.
Yeah.
Ten photo ops and you're married. And then ironically, 11 photo ops and you're divorced. So, this is that tipping point.
15, you're receiving alimony.
You know what, I think I'll do 15 and I'd love to get a piece of there, you know. Wouldn't be so bad. This is so great. We're so excited for you. We have been here all weekend. A lot of you have too. Who here is a Friday person? Yeah. You are our people. You represent what it means to be a supernatural convention goer. You are our heart and soul. The robot bass player have been here for you. And you have been on top, and the relationship is palpable, fantastic, and awesome. And the energy is oh so fantastic. Who here's a Saturday person? You are talking. You fill in gaps. We built a house, and you came through and filled in some gaps. Now now the breeze is not so bad coming through the window. We don't hate you. We appreciate your participation. We're glad you're around-ish. Wouldn't kill you to show up when the show starts, but hey, next year. Who here is a Sunday person? You are squatters on the lawn of the home. Friday people have been here. Sunday people just breeze in. You know what? Weekend's almost over. Let's go see what's going on at the Supernatural Convention. I'll tell you what's going on. A lot of stuff! A lot of cool, fun stuff. A lot of sexy stuff. You know what? Last night, Sunday people, I forgot to tell you, Jared Jensen came out shirtless at the Sunday Night Special. We can lie to the Sunday people. They'll never know. They came and they specifically said, where's that person who's coming on Sunday? I'm attracted to them and want to propose right now. They said, they didn't show up. They won't be here till Sunday. And Jared Jensen put their shirts back on left stage. Downtrodden. Because of you. I hope you're happy. I hope you sleep well. You could have been sleeping well with Jared Jensen. You had to stay home. You think about that.
Can we talk for a second about the legal implications of if they come to the Saturday Night Show next year and they're like, what the F, I was promised naked Jared in this hotel room.
It probably won't happen again because Jared Jensen are very, very sensitive and are probably heartbroken about the big, you know, talk to the hand the Sunday people gave them last night. And my guess is that they won't show up at all next year shirtless at Saturday Night Special like they definitely did last night. So, you really dropped the ball. You really screwed up. I don't think we can get sued for this. I'm pretty sure we're identified.
If we haven't yet.
If you have any problem with what I'm saying, Mike Borjai, B-O-R-J-I, send all complaint letters to Robot Mike Borjai. Wow, people really didn't like what Richard said on stage.
That was not one of your best bits.
Why do you throw me under the bus? You know a bus cannot crush me. I am a robot. Ladies and gentlemen, these aren't robots. These are rock stars. This is Loud and Swaying in my life. Let's take the morning of the boys who've been rocking this joint for the last 72 hours. On the drums, Mr. Stephen Norton. On the bass guitar, a robot that has been built for your bass playing pleasure to hold down the foundation. He bears a striking resemblance to the original bass player, and yet he's a little better. We've made some improvements. Mike Borjai!
Borjai 2.0 right there.
Borjai 2.0, it's good stuff. Speaking of lumbersexuals, on the guitar, a man who's getting a lot of Twitter love these days. I see a lot of people have crushes on this guy, and I don't like it. This man can play anything with six strings on it, an incredibly gifted musician, and a wonderful man, Mr. Billy Moran. This smokes shit, people. I'm stoned on that masculine bust rolling off this stage. You're in the back row right now. Jared Jensen will be out here. He'll be there about 5 minutes. Like, I don't smell that musk Rich was talking about. I don't feel hot. Oh, Jesus. Oh. It'll take a while for it to get the back.
It takes a few seconds to get back there.
It can take a while. So
but just wait.
Compose yourself. Here's what'll happen. You'll have your phone out, you'll be filming it, and all of a sudden you'll be filming it. You'll just hear a very loud voice from the phone go, oh, sweet Jesus, oh, God. That's when you know they've been hit by the monster. a sort of wave of fragrance has rolled over you, and you won't want to shower for weeks because it's become a part of
it. Well, in fact, in this area of downtown, I know they stop traffic because their accidents will happen. Just people that are walking their car.
People who don't even know the show.
Oh,
yeah, honey, I'll be home soon. I'm gonna stop by the grocery store. Officer, sir, have you been drinking? No, God. Somebody get help. Something wrong with that police.
I'm for the CBS News. I'm down here. Live.
Cameraman's like, Rob, are you a cook? We're trying to simulate. I forgot to introduce one member of the band. The front man of the album swing, the lead singer, the guitar player, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rob Behan. I got hit by the bus! Don't blame me, blame the bus! Hashtag blame the bus!
Richard, it's totally okay.
Richard, I'm very offended, Tahmoh. Where have you been, little young lady? Sorry, Dad, my phone went out and I couldn't call you. I'm late, I'm so sorry. Don't get mad at me. You're grandpa. Nobody can resist. Hashtag blame the Musk. Anything that goes wrong in your life, hashtag blame the Musk. Understand me? I got an F on my paper and I studied that paper. That's not cool. Hashtag blame the Musk. My marriage is falling apart. Hashtag blame the Musk. My hairpiece looks like a hairpiece, doesn't it? Hashtag blame the Musk. That's all you have to do in life.
The show's running late because of our long monologue.
Hashtag blame the Musk. But you know what can't be stopped by the Musk? The incredible talent, the incredible comedy, and the creation, the incredible giving spirit of the front man of this band. Lead singer, guitar player, lyricist, and he plays God on your favorite TV show. Stage. That tambourine solo supposed to go on for another 5-6 minutes. You know what happened? Like the Musk. Ladies and gentlemen, that is on the swing. I am Richard Swain. We are your entertainers for the weekend.
So I messed up again, didn't I?
It's a Sunday.
Are you gonna go my way?
Speaking of starting the show, our first guest
is upon us.
Is upon us. I hope he's not upon us. He could beat the living tar out of us.
That's true.
He's awesome, talented, dangerously handsome, and has the best damn diction I've ever heard in a room. Ladies and gentlemen, from Whitehorse, Yukon, Tahmoh Penikett! Pre-voted. Jumped on a red eye last night and got here at some ungodly hour this morning. I got a couple more hours. I'm doing better than an hour and a half I had the last show. Who pre-voted? Who's gonna vote? They're expecting you not to prove them wrong. Let's get into it. Hi.
Hello. First of all, I love you on Supernatural and also on Battlestar Galactica. But my question is, what was the hardest thing physically or emotionally that you've done on like Supernatural or any other show that you've done?
That's a good question. I've been doing this for 14 years now, so there's been some challenging scenes. You said you were a Battlestar fan?
Yes, huge fan.
Yeah, the scene where I had to, shoot my wife was challenging.
Pretty sure I cried for that scene.
Yeah, it was a powerful scene. But you know the thing about that scene? He's 3 years in, because we were in the third season at that point. Most of the actors on the show so believed in their characters and our storyline. There wasn't, you often didn't have to do a lot of extra work. It was there. We were those characters. We believed in the incredible writing that they were doing, and we believed in taking that journey with them. So when I read it on the page, I knew that I had to go to a certain place to do it, but it was there. And I was confident about it, and we only did it in a few days. I had an amazing relationship with Grace Park, very safe relationship, and I knew that, we could go to that place together, and it's about trust with actors, and the director. Pardon me. Oh, sorry, I'm holding the way. Anyway, the director is one of the key producers on it. He was one of the producers on our show. Was our key director, Michael Reimer. So he was fantastic. So that's probably one of the toughest scenes I've had to do, and easy at the same time.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
So my question is not actually about Supernatural. I love Rift World Chronicles. And if any of you guys haven't seen it, I highly, highly recommend it. Watch it. So my question is, how did Rift World come about, and what are the plans for season two? And also, if it would be picked up by like the CW, because I think it definitely needs to be like a full show. I need more of it. And also, did you enjoy filming in Toronto?
Okay, it's like five questions. I'm still kind of sleepy from travel. It came about. Is there a huge echo? Does that sound okay, guys? Okay, good. My agent told me that she got a quirky little script, as she put it. Short film that I could do right after I was planning a trip to Thailand to go and train Muay Thai. It was a lifelong dream of mine. This is about 3 years ago. And she said, right when you're planning to come back, or if you can cut your trip a little short, there's this short film you can do. It's really good. She's like, Tahmoh, you gotta read it. It's funny. I think you'd enjoy it. It's it's not, you know, you haven't done anything like it. So I read it and I was like, yeah, that'd be pretty good. But the biggest selling point was that the other lead was going to be Aaron Karpluck, who's a dear friend of mine. We went to acting school together. Very, very talented. We, even though we've been roommates, we went to acting school together, we never shared a scene together professionally. We were even doing back-to-back plays in acting school years ago at the same acting school. We never shared a scene together. So that was the biggest thing for me. I think the second part was, are we going to see a second season? I don't know. I need to have a meeting with the producers and Jonathan, who wrote and directed these scripts. Jonathan is very, very talented. I think it's deserving of more. I want to give it to the fans. The response has been overwhelming. And if you guys haven't seen it, check it out. You can watch it in under an hour. There's like 8 episodes. The webisodes, they're 5 to 7 minutes long. It's just fun, quirky, dramatic. I had a blast doing it. The writing's exceptional. The production value looks really good. Support it. Give it a retweet if you like it. If you don't, retweet it anyway. So we'll see what's going to happen. There were some positive things happening, and there was some momentum, and then I feel like it's kind of tapered off as of late. So I'm a little out of touch with what's going on with it, but I'm hoping there's going to be more. And whether we give it to you in a miniseries format or a movie or something, but there's going to be something else for sure.
Thank you.
So, as an angel, you would know that it took the 4 archangels to defeat the darkness before heaven was created. Is it fair to assume that the angelic host will come back?
The angelic
host.
I wish I was in the writing room. I wish I was hanging out with the executive producers of the show. I don't know, the opportunity's there. I mean, that's a really good point. You could see it. And as we all know, anybody and anything can happen in Supernatural. So if these guys want enough, it will happen. Thank you.
We all love Supernatural, that's why we're here. But if you had to choose from, say, your 3 biggest, which would be, of course, Cold Case, Battlestar Galactica, and Dollhouse, which would be excluding Supernatural, obviously, because we're all here because we love it, but which would have been your favorite for filming and entertainment?
Well, you know, they all had, there was all wonderful things about them. You know, I got to work with some really, really, really talented people. You know, Joss Whedon and Tim Minear and all the writers that he had in that show. And then, you know, the incredible cast. So Dollhouse was an experience in of itself. And Cold Squad was pretty amazing too. That was, early in my career, and it was my first series because I did the miniseries of Battlestar, but I wasn't a regular. My character was supposed to die after the miniseries. So Cold Squad was a fantastic experience for me too. I'd have to say the most formative and powerful experience was definitely, and learning experience was Battlestar. You know, I did that almost 6 years. And when you have Academy Award nominees, like your 2 leads are Academy Award nominees, they've each been in the business for 40 years each. They've been doing it. They're such veterans. And they're such kind, giving individuals. There's so many things I could go on and say about that show. The entire experience was incredible. Terrifying at times. In the beginning, many of the young actors, we were so intimidated. We were surrounded by these incredible veteran actors. Michael Hogan, also a great Canadian actor. Canadian royalty. And he's often referred to as our Gene Hackman. Michael's been in the business for 50 years. He started as Sean Stratford, him and his wife. He's a fantastic actor. So the young actors on the show were, you know, a little intimidated, but in situations like that, you either step up to the plate or you don't. You get left behind. And I think because of the writing and because those veteran actors were so encouraging, they were so kind, and they
they really gave us the confidence to make us feel like we belong there. I think most of us really did step up to the plate when the time called, and obviously because of the writing and everyone involved, you know, from all the departments, that show was just an incredible experience for me.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.